state wide agitation that we are planning demonstrations in every district in Tamil Nadu, demanding that the central court should be completely boycotted and state government must only continue to implement the state law and protect the state welfare boards. The central government has brought in 4 labor codes and taking away the rights of not only the organized sector workers but also the unorganized sector workers. For example, they call the codes as, you know, due to a process of amalgamation of existing laws and universalization. Actually, it is neither amalgamation nor universalization. In fact, the whatever we had achieved in the building and construction workers at the national level, 96, we got 2 central laws, and whatever safety was there has been removed entirely in the new codes. So it is not really amalgamation, it's selective, you know, kind of combination, so that in order to deny the labor rights of the unorganized workers. Same way, I can give you any number of examples. And as far as the social security code is concerned, for the unorganized workers, they are looking at only one welfare board. Apart from building workers welfare board, only one welfare board. And in Tamil Nadu, we have had a long history. From 82, in 82, we got the Tamil Nadu Manual Workers Act after 3-4 years of struggle of the building workers and also many other groups of workers. And under this law, the welfare board for building workers was formed in 1995, and the welfare boards for other categories were formed in between 99 and 2000. And then by 2006, multiple welfare boards were formed due to the various unions agitating for separate welfare boards. And now we have 18 welfare boards under the Tamil Nadu Manual Workers Act. And there are many other welfare boards, like for the fisheries, there is a welfare board under a separate law for fish work. And then there are many welfare boards under various GOs. What we are trying to say is, why should we go under the Central Act? We have a better law, we have better welfare boards, and we must continue with the existing welfare boards and take them forward and make them better. And in fact, whatever rights have been denied by central government can also be brought under the state law. Instead of that, the government should not decide to go under the central law. That is our primary demand. The second one is that even there should be a medical, ESI medical coverage or a special occupational health coverage for the unorganized workers. And we want the pension to be 3,000. And we want also education assistance for children from the first standard to the higher education. If you look at the central code, they say that the pension will be decided by central government. Assistance for natural death will be decided by central government. And what do they have now, a scheme for natural death? They will give 2 lakhs, but only for any worker who dies below 50 years. The same scheme was tried out in Pondicherry and they found that not a single person who died could get the benefit, because all the workers who died due to natural death on the previous year were all above 50 years. Actually, the previous government had given an okay to the central court. That is the real problem we are now faced with. So at least this government has to review the decision. And after all these multiple welfare boards were brought in by the earlier DMK government. You know, by Kalaignar only, all these multiple welfare boards were brought. So these people should come forward and protect that. And also not getting to the central code where central government will decide everything. And state government will have no decision making, nor the welfare boards don't have any decision making. So we don't want such a thing to happen. And we definitely think that the state government must come forward and oppose the center on this. See, the central codes do not cover all the workers. And the importantly, even the building workers, They talk about establishment. How many workers get jobs through establishment? That is a big contractor. Many of the building workers, if you go to any city, there are many points where workers assemble and they go to work. So where the mestri will come and call them to work, or the owner will come for take them for repair works. Under our state law, everybody gets registered. But under the central law, it's very difficult to even register. And domestic workers, how many workers are getting a job through any establishment? Very few, maybe 5% through placement agencies. But even placement agencies are not listed in the establishment. So which means what? So basically, these laws are not catering to the real unorganized workers who are not protected, unprotected unorganized workers. They are only thinking in terms of organized sector workers. And within that also, they are ruling out a big chunk of the working class. So basically, this is a discriminatory law, and this is a law which is basically not going to benefit anybody. So we do not want the central code, and we want only our state law.